Baby, from Prince's debut album, For You, released in 1978. An early version of the song was recorded in 1976 and was included on the demo tape put together that Prince took to various record companies in New York. The subject matter of the song, about an unplanned pregnancy, was believed to have been inspired by experiences some of his friends were having, and not about Prince himself. The track was included as the B-side to Why You Wanna Treat Me So Bad from Prince's second album, Prince. Bambi, one of Prince's first hard rock tracks from his second album, Prince, released in 1979. The track appeared as a B-side to Why You Wanna Treat Me So Bad in the USA and New Zealand, Still Waiting, again in the USA and New Zealand, and Sexy Dancer, only in the UK. It was also released as the album's fifth single in Belgium and the Netherlands only. Prince recorded an awesome live version in 1993 during the Undertaker session, which appeared on the Undertaker live video released in 1995. Prince also performed the track with Third Eyed Girl, a band which was made for a track like this. Billy, unreleased track recorded on the spot during a sound check or rehearsal in 1983. The track lasts for 45 minutes and features Prince playing guitar and spouting improvised lyrics about how cool Billy's sunglasses are, later to be confirmed as Billy Sparks, who you may know from his role in Purple Rain.
Oh, Billy, where'd you buy the glasses?
Baby I'm a Star, from Prince's sixth album Purple Rain, and first to be credited to Prince and the Revolution, released in 1984. Featured in the Purple Rain movie, the track was originally recorded in 1981-82. Prince then recorded a version with the Revolution in 1983, before recording a live version on the 3rd of August 1983 at First Avenue in Minneapolis, the same night I Would Die For You and Purple Rain were recorded. The live version was included on the Purple Rain album after having overdubs added. Baby I'm a Star was used by Tim Burton in an early draft of the Batman movie for the Joker's parade at the end of the film to indicate the type of music he wanted for that scene. After Prince agreed to record the soundtrack, he submitted 200 balloons, which was rejected and replaced by Trust. The Beautiful Ones, also from the Purple Rain album and movie, this stunning track deals with the confusion, the passion, the love, anger and frustration being in love can throw at you. Famous for Prince's desperate screams and pleas at the end of the track, it quickly became a fan favourite and a highlight of many Prince shows down the years. A live version is included on the One Night Alone box set released in 2002. The Bird, from The Time's third album, Ice Cream Castle, released in 1984. Like most of The Time's music, The Bird was written by Morris Day and Prince under his pseudonym Jamie Starr. Although it's also been said by Jesse Johnson that the original idea for the track came from a version he recorded on the 1999 tour. Prince apparently took the hook of the track and discarded the rest and wrote The Bird. Jesse Johnson's name was included on the credits when it was submitted for copyright, but later removed when Johnson left the band. The track was released as the second single from the album and features in the Purple Rain movie. A studio version was recorded in 1983, but the released version was a live recording from The Time's concert at First Avenue, Minneapolis on the 4th of October, 1983. The Ballad of Dorothy Parker, from Prince's ninth album, Sign of the Times, released in 1987. The track was recorded in 1986 and was included on configurations of the cancelled projects Dream Factory and Crystal Ball, which eventually became Sign of the Times. The track's weak and murky sound came from a problem with the studio console, which had just been installed in Prince's home. The track was the first recorded using the new home studio. During the installation, there was a power loss in the house. The console had two power supplies, positive and negative, and during the recording, one of the power supplies didn't come back up. However, Prince was happy with the recording, and it was left that way. Prince denied the title was referring to Dorothy Parker, an American writer and poet, born in 1893, claiming the name came to him in a dream. Prince does reference Joni Mitchell's Help Me, Think I'm Falling in Love Again from her 1974 album, Court and Spark.
Dorothy was a waitress on a promenade. She worked a night shift.
The Black Album, also dubbed the Funk Bible, Prince's 16th album, originally due for release on the 8th of December 1987. Due to be released with no title or credited artist, it was dubbed the Black Album due to its plain black sleeve with only a catalogue number in peach on the spine. It contains 8 tracks, which were recorded between September 1986 and March 1987. The album was famously cancelled by Prince just 1 week before its release. There are a few stories as to what happened, but Prince has said he felt the album to be too hateful and negative, and if he suddenly died, he didn't want it to be the last thing he released and be remembered for. What brought about this decision was said by Prince to be a dark night of the soul, and that the album was the fault of an evil entity called Spooky Electric. Prince claimed he had experienced a spiritual epiphany and became convinced the album was evil. Others have said that all of this came about from a bad experience from a one-time use of ecstasy. The music was said to be an attempt by Prince to win back his black audience after being criticised for becoming too pop and mainstream. Yeah! Let's go. A 100 European promotional copies were left in circulation and several American copies after its cancellation, leading it to become one of the most bootleg albums in history. The album was eventually released by Warners in November 1994. Although still against Prince's wishes, he did pocket a cool $1 million for the release. It made little impact on the charts, reaching number 47 on the US Billboard 200 and number 36 in the UK Albums Chart. When Two Are In Love, which appeared on Love Sexy, was also first included here on the Black Album, although it's strangely out of place amongst the other darker edge tracks. When Two Are In Love later went on to appear on the Scandalous Sex Suite too. Some of the tracks from the Black Album were performed during the first half of the Love Sexy shows in 1988 and could be seen on the VHS video release at that time.
New coat, huh? That's nice. Did you buy it? Yeah, right. You seeing that bitch motherfucker again.
Batman, Prince's 11th album, released in 1989, and the soundtrack to Tim Burton's 1989 motion picture. Director Tim Burton had used 1999 and Baby I'm a Star in a rough cut of the movie, and felt they'd work well, so approached Prince to re-record the tracks or provide new tracks for the film. Prince wasn't convinced on the idea until he visited the set in England and saw some footage of the film. Prince became so interested in the project that he wanted to cancel the Japanese leg of the Love Sexy tour so he could begin work on it. That idea would prove too costly, so Prince had to wait. Prince began recording songs for the film the moment he returned in February 1989 from the Love Sexy tour. By late February, Prince had recorded 11 songs and previewed them, including Raven to the Joy Fantastic and 200 Balloons, intended to replace 1999 and Baby I'm a Star. Raven to the Joy and 200 Balloons were rejected, and Prince replaced them with Party Man and Trust. While most of the album was recorded between February and March of 1989, three of the tracks were recorded in 1988. Electric Chair, Vicky Waiting, originally titled Anna Waiting, and wrote for Anna Garcia, and Scandalous. The album was released in June 1989 and was a great success, riding off the back of the movie's huge success. It reached number one in the US on the Billboard Top Pop Albums chart and number one in three European countries, including the UK. It produced five singles: Bat Dance, which was released prior to the album and was a massive hit, reaching number one in the US on three Billboard charts, including the Hot 100. It was also a massive hit across Europe, hit number two in the UK, and was a top five single in Belgium, France, Ireland, and the Netherlands. Get the fuck up, the other singles were not so successful. Party Man reached number 18 in the US and the UK number 16. The Arms of Orion, number 36 in the US and number 27 in the UK. Scandalous, which didn't chart on the Billboard Hot 100, but did make number 5 on the Billboard Black Singles chart. It wasn't released in the UK, but reached its highest position in Europe of number 17 in Austria. Scandalous! A maxi single, The Scandalous Sex Suite, was released a month after the single. The final single released was The Future, which was released in Europe only, and only in a remixed form by producer William Orbit. It failed to chart in the UK, but reached its highest position of number 7 in the Netherlands. The Batman singles also produced some of Prince's best B-sides, including I Love You In Me and Fill You Up, short and long strokes, depending on which format you got, and the rejected 200 Balloons. The album also had an incredible track that was left off by Prince called Dance with the Devil, which Prince felt to be too dark. In hindsight, it would have fit the movie perfectly, and with 2019 being the album's 30th anniversary, it would be incredible to have a re-release of the album, remastered and including all the B-sides and remixes, including The Scandalous Sex Suite and Dance with the Devil, and maybe even a DVD with all the videos too. Dance with the devil in the pale moonlight, and put your arms around him and hold him tight. Give up to the feeling and don't try to fight. He wants your soul and he wants it tonight. Blue Light, from Prince's 14th album Love Symbol, released in 1992. This mild attempt at a reggae track was recorded in 1991 and was the earliest recorded track for the album. It was planned as a single release in 1993 with a test pressing made, but was left unreleased. You like it in the dark, but I like a blue light. Can you turn on a blue light? Then cuddle up to me so. Black Motherfuckers in the House, from the New Power Generation's first solo album, Gold Nigger. Believed to have been recorded between 1991 and 1992, this track, despite its controversial title, is actually a message against racism and makes fun at how ridiculous racist people are, with Prince playing the part of a racist redneck, aghast at the prospect of letting these brothers into their club. The track contains a harmonica part which is sampled from I Can't Stand It by the Chambers Brothers from their 1967 album The Time Has Come. The same sample was also used in Thieves in the Temple. Boy, don't you holler at me. I hate it.
Raw in the ass, I don't back
from it, boy.
I don't like crackers in my
You know I will cut your ass three ways, long, deep, and constant.
Come on, y'all.
Stop racism now.
The Beautiful Experience EP, released in May 1994. This EP followed up the enormously successful single, The Most Beautiful Girl in the World, which had given Prince his one and only UK number one single in April of 1994. This EP contains seven versions, including the release single. Two singles were released without charting, Mustang Mix and Staxawax. The EP charted in the UK singles chart at number 18. At that time in the UK, EPs were only allowed to chart on the singles chart. In the US, it charted at number 92 on the US Billboard. Prince famously performed the Mustang Mix on Top of the Pops in the UK when The Most Beautiful Girl hit number one. Big Fun, from the New Power Generation's second album, Exodus, released in 1995. Recorded between December 1994 and January 1995, the track also features saxophone and flute by Eric Leeds. Lyrics from the track were reused on New Power Soul from the New Power Soul album, and the music from the track was reused on Poom Poom, which is on Crystal Ball. Get freaky, let your head bob. Get freaky, let the head bob. Get freaky, let the head bob. Get freaky. Billy Jack Bitch from Prince's 17th album, The Gold Experience, released in September of 1995. This amazing track was originally recorded in 1993, and its chorus features Lenny Kravitz on background vocals, though he was not credited on the official release due to being on a different record label. It also features horns from the Hornheads track, New Del Inn, from their debut album, Hornheads. The track's lyrics are aimed at Minneapolis gossip columnist Cheryl Johnson, or CJ, who regularly wrote negative articles about Prince, calling him Cymbalina.
What if I call you silly names? Just like the ones that you call me.
Betcha by Golly Wow, from Prince's 19th album, Emancipation, released in 1996. This track was originally recorded by the Stylistics in 1971. The track was released as the first single from Emancipation and marked the first time Prince had released a cover version. It was released on Maite's 23rd birthday and charted on multiple Billboard charts, its highest position reaching number 10 on both the Hot R&B Hip Hop Airplay and Rhythmic Top 40 charts. In the UK, it charted at number 11.
Bet you by golly, wow. You're the one that I've been waiting for forever.
Barcelona from Kama Sutra, the first and only album by the MPG Orchestra, released originally in 1997 and then again as part of Crystal Ball for those who ordered the album direct. Written by Prince, it's believed the track was recorded at some point in 1994 and features orchestral overdubs by Claire Fisher's orchestra. Baby Knows from Prince's 23rd album, Raven to the Joy Fantastic, released in 1999. Recorded during the summer of 1999, this track features Sheryl Crow on co-lead vocals and harmonica. Michael B also features on drums. An extended version was included on the companion album, Rave Into the Joy Fantastic, in 2001. On Maceo Parker's album, Die on Maceo, released in 2000, an instrumental version features as a hidden bonus track, featuring saxophone overdubs by Maceo. Beautiful Strange, first seen in 1998 on the home video Beautiful Strange, which was broadcast on Channel 4 in the UK as Beautiful Strange, A Night for Prince. A short segment was shown of Prince recording the track in the studio at Paisley Park before being interviewed by Mel B of Spice Girls fame. The track then appeared on the Rave Into the Joy Fantastic album in 2001. The Beautiful Strange Night on UK TV also featured footage from Prince's after-show party at the Café de Paris in London, featuring the MPG, Larry Graham, Dougie Fresh and Chaka Khan.
Strangely beautiful, beautiful strange.
Black Sweat from 3121, Prince's 31st album, released in 2006. This amazing, funky track is like Kiss for a new generation. It was released as a download single a month before the album's release, and then released as a CD single in Europe a week after the album's release. A live version from Prince's final full show on the 14th of April 2016, Fox Theatre Atlanta, was made available on Tidal on the 18th of April 2016 as the Purple Pick of the Week. This became the final official release of music by Prince before he passed.
I'm working, working up a black sweat. I'm working, working up a black.
Beautiful Loved and Blessed, also from the 3121 album. This track features co-lead vocals by Tamar Davis. A slightly different version from the album features as the B-side to Black Sweat, and also appeared on Tamar's unreleased album Milk and Honey, which was originally titled Beautiful, Loved and Blessed.
Beautiful, loved and blessed. I'm better than the day before, 'cause you made me confess.
Beggin' Woman Blues, from Prince's fourth live album, Indigo Nights, a compilation of aftershows from the 21 Nights in London. The track is a medley of the track by Cousin Joe from the 1947 single Beggin' Woman and Three-Handed Woman by Lewis Jordan and his Timpani Five from the 1950 single Three-Handed Woman. Prince adds additional lyrics. This recording comes from the 17th of September 2007 aftershow following night 19 at the O2.
I got a begging woman.
Oh, it's begging me.
Baby Love, also from the Indigo Nights album. This cover version was recorded on the 22nd September 2007 aftershow, following the 21st and final night at the O2. The song was originally by Mother's Finest from their 1977 album Another Mother Thother. Shelby J sings a powerful lead vocal on this track.
Baby love, early in the morning, you come creeping in.
Boom, from Prince's 33rd album Lotus Flower, released in 2009. Believed to have been recorded in August 2008, this stunning, slightly psychedelic rock track features stunning guitar work by Prince.
Butterscotch mountains, sunshine.
Back to the Lotus, also from the Lotus Flower album. This instrumental closes out the album. Basic tracking took place in 2004 during a famous 3.5 hour session with Michael B and Sonny T. Better With Time, from Prince's 34th album, MPL Sound, released in 2009. According to an interview with Prince, the song was dedicated to actress Kristen Scott Thomas, who played Prince's love interest Mary Sharon in the film Under the Cherry Moon.
This might seem strange, since so much time has passed.
Beginning Endlessly, from Prince's 35th studio album 2010, released in 2010. The track features backing vocals by Shelby J, Liv Warfield and Elisa Dees.
All of the same minerals and chemicals of space you carry within your womb.
Boyfriend, released as a download only through thirdeyedgirl.com in February 2013. The song was taken down not long after and then reappeared an hour later, titled Boyfriend Demo. It is believed that this was the second of three versions recorded, but has never been confirmed.
Please keep your boyfriend away from me, 'cause I just don't wanna fight.
Boy Trouble, from Prince's 36th album, Plectrum Electrum, and the first and only album with Third Eyed Girl, released in 2014. The track features raps by Minneapolis-based artist Lizzo and Sophia Eris.
Boy trouble, whenever we come around.
Breakdown, from Prince's 37th album, Art Official Age, released in 2014. This stunning, heartbreaking ballad appears to be somewhat autobiographical and reflective, with Prince looking back at his past. The track was originally titled The Breakdown and believed to have been recorded in 2012. Prince played it live throughout 2013, and on his appearance on the Arsenio Hall show in 2014, he mentioned it was his favourite current song. The track was then released just before midnight on the 18th of April 2014, the same day Prince re-signed with Warners. The song was then included as a download for pre-orders for Artificial Age in August 2014, along with Clouds.
Keep breaking me down, down, down.
Breakfast Can Wait, also from the Artificial Age album. The track was first available to download 18 months before the album came out on thirdeyedgirl.com, the day the site launched. In August 2013, it was released on ThirdEyeTunes.com, with new artwork showing comedian Dave Chappelle dressed as Prince serving pancakes from a sketch in 2004 on his show. In September 2013, a digital maxi single was released titled The Breakfast Experience, containing remixes of the track by Joshua Welton.
I know you're late, but I need another taste. Breakfast can wait.
Grits and gravy.
Baltimore, opening track to Prince's 39th and final album, Hit and Run Phase 2, recorded in April 2015 in response to the death of Freddie Gray, a 25-year-old African-American man who died while in police custody in Baltimore, and the riots that took place after. Prince gave the track its live debut at his Rally for Peace one-off show in Baltimore in May 2015. People who attended the show were asked to wear something grey in support.
Does anybody hear us pray?